out here.
We are on the right path. Holy fuck. I think this way. This is all fresh. Fuck, here it begins. Okay. Here it fucking begins.
Yeah, looks like they might have even come over this route.
I'm gonna do this now. Okay. It beats trying to grab it later. Of course I can't hook it anywhere. ready? That's John's tracks right there. Stay out of them. Uh-oh. Are you in low range? Yeah. I don't want to go any farther because it's getting softer and softer. Aim this way. Yeah, you want to try to stay on the grass if you can. Oh. Hold up a sec. Let me see if I can gently kind of give a pull and then, but try to get off my tracks. Stay to one side. You know what we didn't bring? Fucking shovel.
No, I have one.
Oh, you do? Okay. Because you should have seen how much stuff you were plowing up there.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, what do we got to lose? not bad at all. Okay. Holy shit, this is steep. Okay, here we go on up the hill. That's not... What the fuck? Holy shit. Thank you. it's not like I can move. I know there's a big fucking rock in there somewhere. Yeah, I can't. I got nothing. Oh my gosh. Should be good. Should be good. This shit is fucking bottomless. Yeah, there's a... That's good. That's good. Yeah. I don't know if I just screwed up the camera, recorded any of that or not, but I'll just redo it just in case. But yeah, we just walked about 2 miles through swamp, and we're setting up here for some night evening calling. See if we can't call something out of the woods. Here we go. It's on. Thank you.
Here's the view this morning. So we ended up not seeing any moose last night. We thought right about 7:30 or so we might have heard a couple of grunts answering, but not for sure. A lot of hunters in the area where we're hunting, they've been calling and Skyping, so we're doing a little bit of glassing of the surrounding hills to see if we can't find something to go after that direction. But yeah, about 34 degrees this morning. Yeah, it's beautiful out here. Well, here we are, six wheelers, all kinds of stuck, 27 inch tires under the mud. Yeah, he's gonna try to go forward through it. I personally would think I'd come out backwards. We don't know. So we hooked up both six wheelers with both winches and we were able to pull it out. Whew. It's pretty awesome. Well, this is the last day at moose camp. Yesterday we did not get a moose, unfortunately. However, it was not without excitement. Jonah, for instance, he was doing a bunch of calling and called in a cow moose, and she proceeded to run up to him and was ready to stomp him into the muskeg, and at the last minute she turned and went the other direction. And then we heard a bull behind the cabin, so I came here to call for that, but didn't have good communication with one of the other guys hunting, and here I was calling it in, but we left. So that was unfortunate. Then last night we went out and some guys went out in the swamp and I went back to where we called the first time, and on the way back 20 feet away from us next to the cabin was a moose. And he ran off into the brush because it was dark and we couldn't see him anyway. So definitely have had quite the experience out here. I actually slept last night, which is good, and now we have to make the big trip home. So at least this time it's not going to be two separate groups, it'll be all of us going together, so that if there's an issue we can actually get somebody unstuck, hopefully a lot quicker. But yeah, we'll find out. This is the hard part coming up. It's a balmy, what is it, 30 degrees this morning. Not enough to freeze anything, just chilly. So that's okay too, I guess. You get pretty warm out there. So yeah, it's a beautiful morning. No rain, thank God for that. So yeah, we'll see you on the trail. So you're promising not to get stuck today, right?
No.
No?
I won't get stuck in the next 15 minutes, I promise.
Okay, let's hold him to it.
Okay. Let's go find some chores in here.
We ain't leaving for 20.
You guys ready to go?
Ready.
Okay.
Whew. Ready? Ready.
Well, here we go. See how long this takes. Stuck. Jonah's stuck, about to get pulled out. We're gonna pull him out forward
And then he'll come around and pull me out. So we got two to pull John through if he gets stuck. Okay, he's out. That's one. Shut it off. Hopefully John can make it. He's bushwhacking her through the trees. Yeah. We got 4 6-wheelers. Both Polarises are stuck. John made it through. Good deal. Okay, John's gonna come around and pull me out, I guess. About 4 minutes after I got stuck and Jonah got stuck, now we got the Can-Am stuck. Might as okay, I gotta move around to the front. She's pretty packed up there with mud. Oh, Lord. Yep, this is steep. Water doesn't look as deep as yesterday. We made that. Who's coming next? Okay. Okay. Thank you.
he goes way up there. Oh, he got off of it. Well, Jonah can turn around and give you a pull, too. Yeah, he's right there. Ooh. Yeah, it hit that.
Okay. All right, go ahead!
Just stop, just grab the winch. Oh, there it goes. Whew, that looked like it was gonna break. Oh. Ground for the moment. Oh, is that nice? Stuck. Okay.
Good.
Looks disturbing though that he's got that much steam here.
He's got a tundra fire on his exhaust.
Well, that
was happening to us last summer with the four wheeler. Yeah. Up on the exhaust.
Yep. Yeah. What's going on?
Fans got jammed up with muck and shit.
Oh, is it?
It got pretty hot. It's cool. It's starting to cool off now because we're getting some water in.
See,
it.
I thought I smelled something for a little bit.
Yeah. That mud hole got some.
So the fan's not coming on at all?
It should be on right now. It's 207 degrees. I mean, it was 228 when I stopped.
And the fan's not coming on?
No.
Did you blow a fuse?
I don't know. It's starting to cool off a little now, but it's 205 now.
Well, they got some of those fins cleaned out.
Oh, yeah. Wow. She's completely packed. But the fan ought to be turning on.
Well, yeah, but if it's got something wedging it, you know.
Yeah. Oh, I don't even know where the fuses are for that. That's diagnostics. It's probably going to be under the seat. I would just shut it off and let it.
Yeah, I was trying to get it to cool off a little first.
Yeah.
Where they?
So when I came out with my four-wheeler, I got a fucking stick that went right here on my radiator, and it pushed my radiator back a little bit.
Oh.
And that's what caused mine to overheat, because the radiator was up against the fan.
Oh, Lord.
Which is